Hey guys, welcome to Rockin' the Country. I'm Don, and I'm doing a reaction video today that was requested by Rusty Shackelford. So Rusty, this one goes out to you. This is Waylon Jennings' song, Too Dumb for New York City. And when I saw that request, he only requested it like a week and a half ago. Rusty, you just gave this to me about a week and a half ago. I saw that title and I said, I've got to react to that song because I've not heard this. I don't know much of Waylon's music. I know some of it, but being a relative newbie to country, just getting into it 10 years ago, there's so much catch-up work to do. So this is off of Waylon Jennings' album, Too Dumb for New York City, Too Ugly for L.A. I don't know. You got to have balls to do something to have a title like that, a sense of humor and confidence. But anyway, today's Saturday. I'm doing this about a half hour before kickoff, so I might be a little amped up for this one. My Rutgers Scarlet Knights are playing in Kansas. They're playing the Kansas Jayhawks in football. Neither team is very good. We're both kind of hoping to get good, as you would, but that's why I'm wearing this red. I'll be a psycho mess in a little bit because it's a game that we actually have a shot at winning, unlike a lot of our other games where we have no shot at winning. All that said, all right, this is off of, this was from 1992, Waylon's song 1992. Waylon was born in Littlefield, Texas. So he was a Texan, and unfortunately, I say he was a Texan because he died in 2002 at the young age of 64 of diabetes. So that's a little bit of background there. So this is sort of like classical artwork, you know? It's like when an artist dies, when they're a famous painter, suddenly their work becomes more valuable. But Waylon was valuable when he was alive. That was his deal. I mean, Waylon's just everybody who knows country music, and I know this, I've learned this from so many people. Waylon is just an institution. So anyway, here we go. Let me get my headphones. There we go. Here it goes. Too Dumb for New York City. Oh, it starts
when
nice.
When I first saw New York City, I was green down to the core.
What a voice.
You could see my redneck glowing for a mile or maybe more. Between the hustlers and the hookers, I must have made their day. They peeled me like an apple lawn and sent me on my way.
Yikes. I will say this, yeah, when you used to go to New York City, you'd go to Times Square, and there was so much, it was so dirty back then. Then Rudy Giuliani, Mayor Giuliani, came in and cleaned it up, and pretty much everybody was thankful that not just outsiders, people who lived in the city, and I'm a Jersey guy, so I spent time in Manhattan. I hated going into New York. You would have the hookers and the prostitutes in Times Square and they just took it over. And whatever Giuliani did with his relationship with the police commissioner and all that, he cleaned it up. It is not dirty the way it was. But I totally respect what Waylon is saying here, that these folks sort of took them.
You're pushed and shoved and almost mugged. It ain't no place to be. So I came to one conclusion. New York ain't for me. From sea to shining sea and coast to coast, somewhere in the middle is the land I love the most.
That's a great line.
I ain't California pretty. I can't survive the great wide way. I'm too dumb for New York City and too ugly for L.A.
And yet he's performed everywhere.
Well, I made my way to Tinseltown, to Hollywood and Vine. Out among those pretty faces, I'd surely find a place for mine. The way I walk, the way I talk, they'll hang on every word. But don't call me, I'll call you is all I ever heard.
This is such good country lyricism right here. So good, right on, like, just even the way it was phrased about, among all these faces, surely there's a place for mine. That is so simple, so reminiscent of just country soil. That this is the only genre that you would find that lyric. That is just, the simplicity of it could blow right past you, but there's a genius in its simplicity. Absolute genius in its simplicity. There's an artistry to being able to come up with a phrase like that.
In LA, what they're thinking ain't what they talk about.
That's true.
At least in New York City.
Yep.
There's never any doubt.
Exactly. I got some, man, this is too much fun. Rusty, this is a great, thanks for the recommendation. In New York City, I've had friends, being a Jersey boy, right? I'm recording this in Florida because my home in Florida. But I've had friends move out to LA or move out to California, and they almost all moved back. Or even those who stayed there just said, man, you can't get people to shoot you straight out here. They just blow smoke up your dress the whole time and tell you you're great, you're wonderful. And I'd read a line once where it's in a book on screenwriting, and the quote at the beginning of one of the chapters said, Hollywood is the only place on earth where one could die of encouragement. And I thought, wow, that sums it up. Because New York, New Jersey, I mean, we're not going to hurt your feelings on purpose. I mean, that's kind of a bad rap. It's kind of a bad depiction. But we'll tell you the truth for the most part. You know, I mean, if you're not that good, we'll break it to you that you're not that good. If you're really good, we'll break it to you that you're good. But for the most part, you'll get some version of someone's truth in New York City. You just won't get cheerleading. But I've had friends move out to L.A., and they moved back east. They couldn't take it. All right, here we go.
From sea to shining sea and coast to coast, somewhere in the middle is the land I love the most.
That's a great, great line.
I ain't California pretty. I can't survive the great white way. I'm too dumb for New York City and too ugly for L.A.
I doubt it. Steel guitar.
I'm too dumb for New York City and too ugly for L.A.
Holy cow. What a fun, fun song. But man, there's heart in there. I mean, there's truth in there that Waylon so seeks or sought in life. About he's from sea to shining sea, in between the coasts. He doesn't like the white foam of the ocean. Get me away from that. Put me in the middle. That's somewhere where I belong. You could just feel... I don't know, just I feel like red dirt soil when I hear a song like this. That's just straight up. So, do I want to rate this song? I mean, I would absolutely give it over a 9. I mean, I would. The thing is, it's like when I rated Charlie Pride's first song, like, you know, and some other of these old-time classics, I just felt irreverent rating them. Like, who am I to judge that, you know? So I'm gonna leave this one alone. Yeah, Rusty, you picked a good one for me. I think you said it's like your favorite song of his, or you just like it. So anyway, and I am gonna do another song by Waylon. That'll be my next review also. And the one after that is gonna be Kris Kristofferson. All right, Wendell, so it's coming, man. Be patient with me. All right, guys. Oh, hit that like button if you think of it, if you've made it this far. Have a great day. Keep rocking the country.